Sports. It's in the game.
EA Sports coverage of the National Football League comes to you from Ford Field here in downtown Detroit, Michigan.
Straight ahead, we've got a pretty good one on tap here as it'll be the Buffalo Bills taking on the Detroit Lions. Tyler Bass about ready to get us going. And we are underway from Ford Field. Here comes Khalif Raymond from his end zone. And this return will net positive as he gets past the 25 and up to the 27-yard line. His way forward to about the 32. 5 yards on the game's first play, second down.
Oh, that was a thing of beauty right there. Look at how quick those blockers fired off the line once the ball was snapped. That was an O-line on a mission, all in sync, and the defense is lucky that play only picked up 5 yards.
And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. First down, Detroit, 16 yards on the pickup.
How best to describe that one? I'd say right down Broadway on that run.
A straight ahead running. I think that might be something we see a lot of between the tackles today.
Well, he's enjoying things so far here this afternoon. Sees a crease and bursts through it for a solid gain.
Brought down by Ed Oliver. From the 48-yard line, here's second and 9. They'll go again with Gibbs. It's a loss of a yard, so it's back to third and 10. Right where this set of downs started, they need a full 10 here to pick up the first down and move the chains. Now a third down throw, but it misses the target, incomplete.
One first down here, and that's all, folks. Good work by this defense to hold things in check and force a punting situation.
Jack Fox out to punt here on fourth down. Back deep, Nyheim Hines. Taken in at the 11. It'll be 37 yards there on the punt. And the Bills will be backed up to start the drive. They'll have it first and 10. Allen and the Bills now with a first and 10 at their own 14-yard line. They'll run with a former member of the Crimson Tide, Damian Harris. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
2 yards on the pickup, and that's all they needed to move the sticks. Allen off the play fake. Open man downfield is Davis. That one nearly 30 yards, 29 officially. So the ball moves into Lion territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 45-yard line. Harris running straight ahead. Tackled by Emmanuel Mosley.
That felt like a trap because it looked to me like the opposing front was on that play from the get-go. They had everyone crashing the ball carrier before he even made the line, and they hold him to just a yard.
So they fake the handoff. Now Allen. And that is caught. It's Davis. And it's going to be another first down as they'll get him to the ground at the Lions' 24-yard line. They run for the first time with James Cook. And he'll manage to pick up about 4. It's second down. From the 21, here's the second down at 6. On play action, Allen. And Davis with it left side. And he's going to be brought down on what will be the final play of this first quarter. We're scoreless after 1. So first and goal from the 9-yard line. They hand this off to Harris, and nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. They'll say no gain on the play, and it'll be second and goal. The free safety roaming all the way up to the line of scrimmage to make that stop.
How about his ability to trust his eyes and figure out it was not a pass play and go fast towards the line of scrimmage in order to make that tackle?
Off the option, that's complete. Touchdown! Gabriel Davis from 10 yards out. And the Bills post the first points of the ball game as they take the lead here in this second quarter. Had the option to hand that one off or run it himself, but instead, a really easy quick pass.
I like the way they made a decisive decision and got it right to the receiver. One move later, he's in the end zone.
Extra point by Bass, up and good. And it's now a 7-0 game. After the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. And it'll come out to the 25 as Raymond will elect not to bring it out. The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. They'll be looking to match that touchdown from a moment ago. 7-0 is the score as they begin with a first down. And he's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7 past the 30 to the 32.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here. And if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs. Run some plays, run some clock. Allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up the score.
9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down. Counterplay, here's Gibbs, and he'll run straight into a wall of tacklers at the line of scrimmage. It's second down.
The running lanes have definitely not been there for him here in the first half, and I don't think it's all been his fault. His offensive line hasn't given him much space. A loss results there.
Now Goff. That's going to be caught by Josh Reynolds. And he's got a first down as the tackle made at the Bills' 38-yard line. Now a give to Gibbs, running left. And he still has yet to get on track in this first half as they're going to stop him behind the line. On second down, here's Goff. Oh, short pass here taken in by LaPorta. He'll be stopped at the 35, but not before he picks up 7 yards. On third down, here's Gibbs. And this play comes to a halt at the 33, and obviously that's well short of the first down. Just a gain of 2 there, and it's going to bring up a 4th down. Goff and his guys not coming off the field. They're going for this. On play action, they'll throw. And they hit him as he throws, as this one's going to go straight down to the turf. Incomplete. The Lions turned away on 4th down. And the Bills are going to get the football back. Buffalo offense ready to go for their next drive. And they'll be looking to make this a 2-score advantage. Had the touchdown on their first drive, Charles. Hey, they can get up 2 scores here on the road. That's a heck of a start.
And not only have they thought about it, I wonder if they visualized it. I remember playing, and they used to turn the lights out in our meeting room and run through a situation like this and say, just think about what it would be like to be up on the road and take the crowd out of it. Maybe they did some of that.
Well, you know they had a 3rd down play on standby just in case, but he says no need with that carry. Runs like that will continually earn him more work in this and future contests.
Throwing on 1st down is Allen. He's got it complete to Stephon Diggs. Yeah, that's good for a gain of 6, and it's 2nd down. From the gun, it's a give to Cook. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. Allen now on 1st down. He's got the connection over the middle to Diggs. Now the Bills are going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with just under 30 seconds to go in the first half. Here's second and a yard. On play action, Allen. Looking for Diggs, and it's intercepted. Picked by Tracy Walker. And the Lions are going to take over at their own 28-yard line. So this defense coming up with a takeaway, and maybe that's something that can bring a little life to that sideline.
Well, I don't want to say that they've been sleepwalking through this first half, because that's simply not true, but you're right. We haven't seen a lot of fire from these guys, really, on either side of the ball. So maybe that's the catalyst that they needed to get them back into this game.
The Lions will use the first of their timeouts. So as they take it over, we step aside. A very solid gain of 27.
Certainly no settling into the drive there. They came right out on the first play and attacked the middle of the field for a big gainer and a first down.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
One thing you hope to see out of a rookie tight end is a real concentration when the ball's in the air, and I'm not sure that he didn't, but he has to be prepared for people making a play on it when that ball's up for grabs.
Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Jordan Poyer. There he goes, right side. So consecutive interceptions here early on in this one, and maybe setting the tone, Charles, for a game where the defense really takes center stage.
And don't you think that both offenses are really catching a bit from their coaching staff about avoiding these turnovers that we've seen early? I think both teams are trying to find an advantage. We know that. Can one of them break away and take control of this game?
And that'll be off the crossbar and out. It's short. He couldn't get it there. It's no good. That's it for the first half. Two more quarters to go. We'll have plenty more to see after the break. And we welcome you back now alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, getting set for quarter number three here. Just the one touchdown in that first half. 7-0 our score as we get going in quarter number three. This fielded right at the goal line. Oh, a dangerous return man showing it here. Still going past the 30. And he is finally stopped. Boy, he almost made it, but not quite. Down around the 5-yard line. What a return.
All praises for a tremendous return, but how about the guys that never gave up on the play, refused to let him get into the end zone, and tracked him down before he got there and made...
And he'll get in! Touchdown, Buffalo! Damian Harris, a 5-yard touchdown run. And the Bills come right out of the locker room and score here in the opening minute of the third quarter. He had the option to hand that football off. I think it's safe to say that he made the right decision. That was a heck of a run.
It certainly was. And when you mentioned the option, most people think the quarterback's not going to keep the ball. You know, in the NFL, that's usually not the recipe for being around too long. So when you do keep it, it often surprises the heck out of a defense.
After the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. Here's Raymond bringing it out. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. They make their second half debut here, and things are looking a little bit tougher now. You give up the points there, Charles, that touchdown drive on the other side. So now it's a two-score game here. Got to be careful.
They certainly do, and I'm just wondering at halftime if those guys just looked in each other's eyes and realized what they've got to get done and come out a little bit more charged up, because if they don't get some kind of points here, that next drive, that could make this a three-possession game.
And he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line. 15 yards for the Lions there on a first down. Now a play fake, and it's Goff. And this will be incomplete.
Offense was moving it a little bit, had them back on their heels, but they earned a brief pause by forcing the incompletion. That gives them a quick chance to regroup and try and mount a stand before they're backed up even further.
Hey, kill, kill! Or, Rick Flair!
St. Brown in motion right.
14.
On second down, here's Gibbs. And he'll be close to a first down as the tackle made at the Bills' 43-yard line. And quickly, they get to the line. Third and two, Goff. He's got his tight end. That's LaPorta with it. And he's got a first down as the tackle made at the Bills' 33. Straight ahead with Gibbs here. And just good downhill running there as he'll take this to the 15-yard line. 65 yards rushing for him now as he's run it 11 times. Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move. First and 10. From the red zone now, Goff. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete. So not quite a first and goal just yet as they come up now second and inches. Toward the pylon, caught. And in for the Lions, touchdown. Sam LaPorta. Five-yard touchdown, and the Lions have cut it back within a score. Extra point by Patterson, up and good, and that'll make our score 14-7. This game back within a touchdown now as the kickoff's away. Touchdown. 87 yards, the official distance on the kickoff return. And the Bills are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. I know a lot of special teams coaches, they just want to keep it away from him because that's what he can do.
And others have egos that their players can't keep up with. And they say, challenge it. Kick it to him. The way he runs, as fast as he is, I wouldn't challenge him at all. I'd do everything possible to keep it away.
He is just a blur when he gets a full head of steam, and he got a full head of steam there. Here's Raymond bringing it out. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. And right now, Charles, it just feels like they're trying to keep pace. They did score the touchdown last time out, but they still trail by double digits here. We'll see if this offense is once again up to the task.
Yeah, and I think that after the last drive, they've gotten pretty revved up, don't you think? Everything they were doing was working pretty well. They go back out there with the same mindset, play at the same tempo and the same pace. Still a lot of time left to make something happen in this one.
That's into a crowd and intercepted. And he's able to get it back here to the 43-yard line. Certainly not his best throw that time, and not a good time to make it, Charles, when they were a nickel with five defensive backs on the field.
And that's exactly why you have those five DBs out there. You want extra speed on the field, guys who have ball skills and understand what the passing game can do, and gives them a chance to react and make a play on the football, and they take one of those away.
A nice looking play to start the drive down the middle and complete. A good pickup there, 26 yards.
And now we get into the psychology of the whole thing, because a lot of teams with a two-score lead in the third quarter, they almost become defensive with their offense, just playing not to lose. I think with this team, you got to figure at this point, this is a great spot for them to go into attack mode, really try and put the hammer down and finish this one off.
He was brought down by big Levi Onwuzurike. So second and 10 now here in the third quarter from Detroit. Allen going to throw. And Diggs has it. They get six. That'll leave them with third and four.
It's a game of matchups, and that's why you take your receivers and move them around a bunch, especially your best guys. And when they work out in the slot, you often hear the coaches talk about how great it is because it gives you a two-way go. You can break out or you can break in. That makes it hard to defend.
And oh, he's just going to be short here, barely. Maybe by a half a foot. It'll be fourth and inches.
Sean McDermott didn't hesitate. They'll go for it on fourth. Allen will look to throw for it on fourth. Yeah, he's got it. Touchdown, Bills. Allen on target there to Stephon Diggs. And the Bills have pretty well put it away here in the fourth quarter. He's got them out now to a three-score lead here in the fourth quarter after that one, CD. And, well, he looked right off the line like he knew that that ball was coming his way, and he secured it for 6 points.
Yeah, I think when you're leading by a healthy margin already, it actually loosens you up and allows you to take maybe a few more chances and definitely play with more confidence, because he certainly saw something he could exploit in the defense, and he made sure to let his quarterback know, just get it to me. And the rest was all up to him, and he delivered and made it a three-score game.
And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. So now, Charles, this drive maybe a touch more important, trying to erase the memory of that interception they had the last time out.
Yeah, and everyone goes through this, because even the best in the game, you're going to have games where it just doesn't go right for you and interceptions result. So, frankly, to me, it's all about how you respond, not just the types of plays that you call, but how you carry yourself, how you show your team that you're still with it, and how you continue to lead.
And yet again, Goff is intercepted. Kyir Elam makes a pick. Off to the races. And they will finally run him down, but not until he brings this one all the way back down inside the 10-yard line. So that changes things. You get the interception, and then to boot, a good return tacked on.
And really, it was down to him versus the quarterback on the return, and that's one you would think the defender would win. But a nice job there of seeing the play all the way to the end and making the tackle by the QB.
Since them days where we raved for 3 days and 4 nights and took them red-eye flights, hopped straight off the plane and threw the back to off.